delicious lemon sole, so fresh. But I want something really simple to kind of marinate in that you can do on the beach, you could do in your barbecue, or you could do at home if it's raining. I'm gonna make a beautiful, easy, homemade rocket pesto. So simple to make. You just need some Parmesan cheese, some lovely pine nuts, I've got 50 grams, and then lovely fresh rocket. When you're kind of out and about and you don't have like a mixer, just put it all into a pestle and mortar. Lots of olive oil on top to help you crush it. And then just stamp it and crush it down. You're gonna get all of these nicely, finely crushed. Then you wanna get your rocket. Nice big bunch of fresh rocket, about that much. And you wanna get this nice and fine. Always think about the bite at the end of the day whenever you're kind of preparing any foods, because you don't want big kind of chewy chunks of rocket in your way. So just get it nice and fine. Other different types of leaves that you could hear is the classic fresh basil, but you can also use lovely coriander, which is really, really beautiful with it. So this is how fine you want it. See, just like that. That's just one nice big bunch. And then the lovely fresh Parmesan cheese. Always try to buy it, you know, whole like this and then just grate it yourself. The problem is when you get already grated Parmesan cheese, A, you're not sure if it is really real Parmesan cheese because there are so many fake Parmesan cheese out there. And as well as that, you lose some of the flavor, obviously, when it's been grated already. So it's 50 grams of Parmesan cheese, 50 grams of pine nuts, and 150 mils of olive oil, and then a big bunch of whatever herb you want to use. Nice big pinch of salt, and then some freshly ground black pepper. And it takes a lot less time than you think, and the ingredients, I mean, the only ingredient that you really need to get that's fresh is the actual leaf, like the rocket leaf or the basil or the parsley. All the others are store cupboard ingredients, so you can have them stocked up in your cupboard. And look at it, doesn't it look absolutely delicious? And the smells are nutty and kind of really flavoursome, fresh flavours from the rocket. Get a big bowl and drizzle in your pesto, like so. Gonna keep a little bit back. I'm using lemon sole because it's in season at the moment. I just wanna marinate them in it. Then on a griddle pan, sizzling. If you can't get your hands on lemon sole, another good fish to use would be plaice. You could also use this with ling or with cod. I try not to use cod as much anymore because it is an endangered species, so I go more for ling or even pollock as well, which is really good. Always with fish, we tend to overcook it as well with our meat, so just try to cook it for a very short time, about 1 minute on each side. See, that's already cooked here. It's a really thin fish. And never be afraid of undercooking your fish. Just think of sushi. People eat fish. As long as you know that your fish is very fresh, you don't have to be afraid of whether you're overcooking it or not. Got some lovely mixed summer salads here, like some rocket. I've also got watercress and some lamb's tongue. And my fish is cooked. You can't tell me that fish doesn't look appetizing. I'm just gonna drizzle over the remaining pesto. And then this can go into the fridge, and as long as it's covered with the olive oil, it'll last for about a month.